Hey friends, it's Amber. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be a coffee chat. So it's been a while since we just kind of chilled out on my couch and had coffee and chatted together, and I think this is like the first coffee chat I'm doing in 2020, which is exciting. And this is a topic that I've wanted to discuss for a while now. It's something that's been on my mind heavily lately because it's impacting a very specific part of my work and my life, which I will talk about later in this video. And you've probably already gauged that from the title, but it's why I hated how much I love Chiclet. If you have been a longtime subscriber or you follow me on my blog or any of my social channels, you know that I read like a pretty wide range of things. I love memoirs that are deep and telling and like emotional. I love fantasy and a little bit of sci-fi. I love young adult books. I love new adult books. Like, I will pretty much read anything that is of interest to me and that makes me happy. I love trying new authors, trying new subgenres. Like, I'm pretty open to reading whatever. I've been a book nerd since I was a kid. Like, my favorite day of the school year was the Scholastic Book Fair. And if you're watching this channel, you can probably relate. Like, I just loved books. I honestly believe that books are kind of magical. Like, you read a book, you fall in love with these characters, you see parts of yourselves in these books, you travel through books. Like, it never really bothered me what kind of book I was reading. And I've always thought of myself of being, you know, like smarter and more engaged and more of a thinker because I've always been a reader. And I don't think it's any like surprise that kids who grow up reading tend to be kids who like have different levels of critical thinking skills. Like, reading is so important and developmental. And so I never, when I was younger, really thought about, I guess, like book snobbery and like all the different levels of readers that there are in your adult life. So let's rewind a little bit to when I kind of got back into reading, because like most people, you know, I read a ton when I was a kid, but then I got to college and you can't really read as much for leisure in college, I feel. At least not if you're in like a crazy like writing intensive major like I was, because you're reading for school. So I probably didn't pick up another book for leisure until maybe like my senior year, like the last semester of my senior year of college. And the two books that I picked up that really reminded me how much I loved just taking an afternoon and getting lost in a book were two romance slash chick lit slash women's fiction books. And those two books were Revenge Wears Prada by Lauren Weisberg. She wrote The Devil Wears Prada. Revenge Wears Prada is like the companion novel slash sequel to that novel, which I honestly loved so much. The Devil Wears Prada is probably one of my favorite movies just because it's always good. You always love watching it. And the second book that I read was called Baby Proof by Emily Giffen, which is another one of like my favorite books because it's just so well done. I had never seen a romance novel take those kinds of turns before. Like, and granted, at this point, I was probably reading this when I was 21 or 22. So prior to that, most of the books that I had been reading that had a romance in them were young adults. So now being an adult and reading adult romance novels, you get a totally different perspective, totally different levels of character development. And I was just hooked. Those two books remind me again how much I love reading. Shortly after that, I think maybe I had picked up like a couple of other books, but I wasn't reading at like the same pace that I read at now. But I was finally getting back into it, discovering new books, visiting my local bookstores, that kind of thing. Wow, but Book of the Month definitely helped me plunge headfirst back into reading and discover books. And around that time, I also discovered BookTube and Bookstagram. So now I'm in this like community of readers, and everyone is reading so many different genres, reading so diversely. There's so many books, discovering so many books, and now that I'm back in, it's like I want to be reading all the time. Anyone who knows me in real life will tell you that I almost never leave my house without a book, and I will read literally anywhere. I read at lunch, at work, I read standing in line at the bank, I'll read like while I'm checking out at the grocery store. Like, if I'm walking down the street and I have like a long walk ahead of me, I'll probably put an audiobook on. Like, I'm always reading because reading for me is so therapeutic. It brings me so much joy. But there is a level of judgment that I don't think we talk about when people have certain expectations of what an adult should be reading. I think this argument can be made even for people who are judgmental of those who are older and read young adult books, but that is a conversation for another time. I was at work recently, not recently, this was a while ago. And I just realized that anytime that I would be bringing a book that was like the chick lit genre with me, even when, not even just at work, when I was just out in the world with a book, I would get so nervous that someone would ask me what my book was about. If you've read a romance novel or are familiar with the genre, you know that they tend to have like quirkier plot points that help to push us towards a romance. For example, a group of roommates take a magic potion which transforms them from average women to like supermodel beautiful women, and they have to learn some lessons from that as they also deal with their romantic escapades. Or a woman with a chronic illness makes a list of things that she can do to get a life despite living with an invisible illness and falls in love in the process. Or a woman meets a man in a hotel and somehow convinces him to be her date to a wedding and, of course, falls in love in the process. Or even more dramatically, a woman's husband dies in a fatal helicopter crash only to come back years later now that she is in love and dating another man, meaning she has to choose between the love she knew and the love she has. It can be kind of awkward telling someone that you're reading a book about one of those topics, but why is it so awkward? I've never felt weird saying I was reading a book about a young boy whose parents died, leaving him to live with his terrible aunt and uncle, only to find out that he's a wizard and is whisked away to a magical school to go on adventures with his friends and save the world from evil. Or that I'm reading about a group of sisters who are navigating their lives during Civil War America, trying to make the best of things and really getting to know themselves. I started to notice my issue and like my gripe with this even more when I started the process of working on my novel. So if you don't follow me on Instagram, you totally should. My Instagram is somewhere on this screen. Make sure you're following me there because I talk about my writing there pretty extensively. I will be bringing that to YouTube, but again, a video for another time. I've always known I wanted to write. I've been writing since, again, I was a kid, and I realized that for years I kept trying to formulate the novel that I thought I should write. Something that was incredibly thoughtful and highbrow and intelligent and that sparked deep conversation, and to me that was not synonymous with writing a woman's fiction novel. Even in a lot of bookstores, if you look at like the geography of a bookstore, I feel like the women's fiction section or like the romance novel section is always kind of like off to the side, sort of in the back, like don't let anyone see you over here browsing these books. The more I tried to formulate a novel in my head, the more I thought about the kind of characters that I wanted to write and the kind of story I wanted to tell, the more I realized that I did want to write a romantic comedy. I did want to write women's fiction. At the end of the day, it really all boils down to the fact that society notoriously takes the things that women love and tries to trivialize them or make them seem immature or frivolous or like a waste of time. And I think you can see this a lot when you look at like who's portrayed as a serious woman. It's never like the woman who wears like form-fitting clothes and has like is like really into fashion, hair and makeup, and will like take the time to spend 45 minutes on her makeup in the morning. It's the woman who's very serious and straight to the point and with very little effort looks so put together. Like, we have these images of who is what kind of woman, and so many times it's just like these things that we love are just trivialized so much. We do the same thing with things that young people like. If you look at TikTok right now, I think that so many people are brushing it off as just something that's for the youth. In a lot of ways it is, but it's also something that seems to be a pretty powerful tool that we might regret not paying more attention to in the next couple of years. That's why I think romance books like The Bromance Book Club, which I read last year and loved, are so important, because that was the first time I think in a romance novel that there had been men reading romance and getting something out of it. I think that that's such a positive image to display, and I feel like that book needs to be way more hyped because I thought it was so well done. So now that I've gotten way more clear on the actual book that I'm writing, I'm so proud to be writing a women's fiction novel. I'm so proud to be writing a romance novel. I'm excited to hopefully create something that makes people laugh and that people can see themselves in and distracts you from just the everyday like stress and anxiety that we all deal with. Like, I just want to give something to the world that is good, and it can be thoughtful and serious and well done and highbrow without being like a literary, like contemporary literary fiction that deals with heavy, serious topics and doesn't focus on romance or isn't targeted towards women. And to be honest, I think I kind of hate that it's called women's fiction or chick lit, because I do wish that more men felt that these books were written with points for them in mind, or that they could go into the bookstore and proudly walk over to this bookshelf and pick something out for themselves, because when did women become the only ones interested in romance? I think that it's incredibly damning to think that men don't also crave these picturesque relationships. And I do understand that because many of these books are written by women, they are written with like the female gaze in mind, but I don't think it has to be that way. I think there are ways that you can write male characters that are appealing to men, especially, and I think it's also important to say that for the most part, a vast majority of these books are very heteronormative. But there are also a lot of really well done romance books, like The Regulars being one of them, that handle queer topics so well. So yeah, I think there's a lot of work that still needs to be done within how we define genres across the board, not even just with women's fiction. Like, a lot of people argue that new adult isn't a real subgenre, or that the lines between YA and new adult and adult are all being blurred. Like, if a character is 17 years old, is it young adult or is it adult? Like, if a character is 24 years old, are you a young adult or are you an adult? Like, those lines are so blurred already, and so much of genreing is to help with where books land in a bookstore or how books are marketed. And I think because of that, a lot of people miss a lot of books because they just feel like it's not being targeted towards them. At the end of the day, we should all just read what we love, try new books out, try new genres. All of the books that I listed in this video, I highly recommend. I think they're great. I'm going to do a blog post soon just on all of my favorite romance novels, because I have read some really good ones over the years, and I really would love to see more people be open to this genre and not just cast it off as a woman's thing. All right, let me know your thoughts in the comment. Do you read women's fiction or romance novels or rom-coms or however you classified them in your mind? Do you think that this is a thing, like people judging people if they're reading like a trashy romance novel versus reading like something more highbrow? So many air quotes in this video. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to my channel. I upload new videos every single week, and I have a lot of new writing videos coming out soon that I'm super excited to share with you guys. Clearly the light is slipping away from me. I don't know what is going on with the sun right now, but just we're wrapping up this chat anyway, so it's fine. Everything's fine. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.